Hey, if you're like me, you've got lots of PDFs everywhere. You're downloading all kinds of things like manuals, and you've got little how-to guides, and you've got checklists, and you've got handbooks and all kinds of stuff like that. The question is, how do you make use of all that stuff? We get these PDFs. We want to get this information. We want to hold on to all this digital knowledge and stuff. So how are you doing? Are you keeping it in Google Drive and then having to navigate around and try to find all this sort of stuff? Let me show you something. It's called Send to Kindle. What's cool about the Kindle is you can access your stuff anywhere. They've got apps for obviously the Amazon Kindle Fire devices. They've got apps for your Android devices, for your iOS devices. They've got a Chrome web player, like a cloud reader, basically, for the Kindle stuff. You can access your Kindle library anywhere, which is amazing. Now, the question is, how do you get stuff that's not Kindle books onto your Kindle app? Well, you use something called the Send to Kindle app. It's basically a service that Amazon has put together that lets you send things to your Kindle library, which means you can send documents, you can send PDF files, you can send images, you can send web pages, you can send all kinds of stuff, and you can do it many different ways, through the desktop app, through extensions for your browsers. You can email them to your Kindle device, specific devices. It's really cool. Let me show you how this works. Okay, so on the desktop here, I've got the little Send to Kindle app, okay? It's just, I downloaded it from their store. In fact, let me show you. If we jump over to Amazon's website, amazon.com/GP/Send to Kindle, you can get Send to Kindle any way you need it. So if you want to do it from your desktop, you can grab it for your PC, you can grab it for the Mac. It'll just download the little DMG file or the EXE file. You'll install it, and it'll be there for you. If you want to do it from your browser, really cool, you can actually get a Chrome extension, or you can get a Firefox extension. You can also do it by your email, okay? So for every single device that you have, they give you a list of emails that you can use that are specific to that device. For example, I've got a whole bunch of different devices I've had over the years, and each one has a unique email address associated with it. Dave47675@kindle.com is my iPad. And if I email a PDF or a doc or an HTML file or whatever to this email address, it will show up on that device. Pretty darn cool. You can also, really cool, go in and change it. Okay, so let's just, let's see. All right, so here, I made this one right here. Dave's Moto X Pure, that's my phone. So I changed it from this weird number to Dave_MotoX@Kindle.com. So if I send it to Dave_MotoX@Kindle.com, it will show up on the device. I've got an iPad mini here. We'll see that it's Dave95130@Kindle.com. All I need to do is edit that. And I'm going to make it this DaveC-iPad mini. And boom, successfully changed the email address, Dave_C-iPad mini. So if I send any document to that email address, it will show up on my Kindle. By the way, don't do that. Don't start sending me your documents. Anyway, when you grab the Send to Kindle app, it's going to download and give you this nice little thing right here, which is really cool. Now, let's go to options real quick. I want to show you something. You have the option to convert it to the Kindle format, convert PDF documents to Kindle format. Now, I'm going to show you why I'm not doing that. The reason is because sometimes it just doesn't work. Depending on the formatting of your document, I mean, if it's a basic document, then pretty much it's going to translate one-to-one. It's going to be okay. But if you've got a bunch of images and a bunch of weird formatting and a whole bunch of odd things like that, it's going to get kind of funky. So I'll show you that in a sec. I prefer just to send the PDF over there and have it show up in my library. And then I can manage it by putting it into a collection, you know, or whatever. So let me show you how we do this. Very simple. Here it is. The Live Streaming for Churches, the Easy Way PDF, right? There it is, the whole shooting match. And I drag it over here, and I go in and make sure that I have the title the way I want it, have the author the way I want it. Where do I want to send it? I'm going to be sending it to, my Moto X Pure and my iPad Mini. There you go. It's going to show up on both of those. Archive the document in my Kindle library, so it's always there. I can do that, or I cannot. It really depends. I kind of like to keep them all in there so that no matter what happens, I don't have to like resend it at another time. And then hit send, and it's going to do it. And that's it. You just now have to wait for a confirmation email and then wait for it to actually show up in there. And it could take a couple of minutes. It could take you know, 10 minutes. It just really depends on what's going on the Amazon side of it. Now, let's take a look at my mini. Here's, I did this earlier, and I'll show you. I've got a couple of different things in here, but let me show you. This is the one right here that I did the actual Kindle conversion on. And when you take a look at it, you can see it's really not that great. I mean, it looks okay right here, but as soon as we start getting into the way I've formatted stuff in the PDF, it starts getting really weird. I mean, look at all this stuff down here at the bottom. That's just wrong. You know, the images are not in the appropriate places because I'm using tables to get them lined. I mean, it's funky. It's really not that great. So it didn't work for this one. That's why I kind of just always do the PDF anyway. So when you open up the PDF, there you go. Now it looks like it's supposed to. There's my cover. See, the images are lined up properly. The extra stuff that I did, the little post-it note and the links and the way the table is lined out, all these things, see, I mean, it's all lined up exactly the way I want it. But the cool thing is it's available to me on my Kindle device, on my tablet, in the Kindle app, however I need it. Another way you can do it is you can actually use it to send things from your browser, which means if you're looking at a PDF or if you're looking at a web page, you can actually send it here. So here's the Send to Kindle Chrome extension. Now, I've already got that installed, and it is right here, okay? Now, one thing to note is that in the settings for the Send to Kindle Chrome extension, you can determine what is the default device that it goes to. So I don't want to send it to my Galaxy Tab. I want it going to my iPad Mini, and I want it going to my Moto X Pure, okay? So I can hit Save. That is done, and then when I have my article that I want to do, all I need to do is select from the drop-down box up here from the Send to Kindle little Chrome extension, Preview and Send, and it's going to show my article with the images, etc. Your mileage, again, may vary depending on how formatted your article is. But I hit send, and it's going to go. Okay, so here I am looking at all the documents and books and all that stuff in my Kindle library. If I wanted to get a little more specific, I could go to the docs section if I were looking for one of the things that I uploaded. And here's all the different PDFs and stuff. And right here is the web page that I was looking at. And there it is. So now I have this available to me in a very easy, portable format that I can use anytime that I need to. So Send to Kindle, extremely cool. I like it because I can take camera manuals. I can take the manual for my TriCaster, the manual for our soundboard, all these sort of things, and keep them all in one location that I can have access to. And because I also keep those things in my Google Drive, I could actually send those to individuals on my team. So if I've got a new camera guy, and he's going to be running this camera for a while, I'll go ahead and send him a copy of the manual. That way, you know, if he's like, how do I white balance or how do I adjust the iris? Okay, well, there you go. It's right there in the manual. You can also do this with your checklist. You can do this with the little how-to guides that you have for, you know, your TriCaster or your OBS software or the checklist that you use to go through the startup procedure for getting all your audio equipment turned on, all that kind of stuff. Anyway, it's really cool. Send to Kindle, totally free. I like it. Tell me how you're using it.